leaders, man. You got motherfuckers in New York City that stab motherfuckers, man. We talking about a misdemeanor here. We talking about no marks, no bruises, no nothing. Show me some pictures first. Things happen. You know, you live life, you learn. I don't have nothing negative to say. I'm a boxer. I'm a fighter. Right. Will Floyd Mayweather be a changed right. person? I'm a changed person now.
Yeah. Y'all want to go into the courtroom? Y'all want to go to the courtroom. I got to go. Come on.
Sometimes shit happens. The only thing you can do is just always try to become a better person and work at becoming a better person. I guess the time that I'm going away, I'm going to find out, you know, who's really behind me and give me a time to just sit back and reflect on my life.
Mayweather at this time will be remanded in custody serving the next data check will be November 15th at
1 month. I dreamed it. I dreamed that one day I'll put asses in a seat like Tyson, like Muhammad Ali, Sugar Ray Leonard. Those guys opened the door for me to be where I'm at. Me and all other boxers, we're all selling the same product. And my sales pitch is one of a kind. I think it's a great thing that my name is still out there in the world, and I'm not far from 40 years old. To be relevant from a teenager to almost 40 is, it's amazing. I just feel like when I go to an arena, if the fans see me, the fans cheer, it's a great thing. If the fans boo, it's a great thing because at least they're letting me know that they know who I am.
Floyd Mayweather, I believe, has won this WBA Super Welterweight Championship in fine style.
I took a shower for like an hour. Just sat in the shower and drunk Mountain Dew. I had to wash my body at least, you know, 3 or 4 times to make sure there wasn't no blood on me.
That's the last one.
All right, 5-0.
I'm really disappointed that I didn't get the knockout. I tried.
Hey guys, you
want a band-aid? Anybody got a band-aid?
He does.
No, he doesn't, John.
He does.
It's not the real Justin.
Darby, you got Instagram too?
Yeah. I do.
I don't know if this is my last fight tonight.
No.
Maybe.
No.
It was tough tonight. That motherfucker made me go on retirement. That bitch was tough. Uppercuts, hooks.
I'm gonna go, sweetie. I gotta go. It's good to see you.
Good to see you too.
I gotta go. Can I hug?
Oh, Gyro!
He must be a Pisces if you got a fish.
Exactly.
Well, guess what? I'm a Pisces too. That's my man. Justin, let's get this money beat, but just like that. You know what I'm saying? If you ain't seen this movie, you better go check it out. It's my dude.
It's my dude right here, the champ.
You see this? Man. The money team to the day with D.I.E. Now you know L.I.E. Justin Bieber, Canadian, worldwide. This is the future of entertainment.
That's a shout out right there, man.
That's my dude.
All right, man. Thank you so much, bro.
So what else we got?
If I'm Incredible Hulk, we just say superheroes, right? If I'm Incredible Hulk, you know, I want to fight Superman. I want to fight Batman. I want to fight Captain America.
Yeah, well worth it. Oh, it's dedication, baby.
Floyd, do you think that the nature of this fight can do anything to bring Pacquiao or Aaron closer to you?
Pacquiao made what the fight's not going to happen. I'm trying. This fight's not going to happen. Y'all keep asking the same question over and over and over again. It's not my fault. Mayweather Promotions, I run my company. He has a boss. Pacquiao has a boss. I don't answer to nobody. He has to answer to somebody. Someone gives him a date to fight. No one gives me a date. I make up my own date. This is Cinco de Mayo. Here's my date.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, man. Living in my shoes, man, it's rough. It's rough. But you know, it's just that I think my mentality is like, you know, fuck it. It's gonna be what it's gonna be.
Feed my family. That was very, very important. When you feed your loved ones, you want them to be appreciative and to be thankful.
Within life, we learn to take the bitter with the sweet. Sometimes we get a good hand dealt to us, sometimes we get a bad hand. Whatever, we just play the game.
This one isn't done.
I had it when I was 21. Oh, we had some bad times. Some tough times, but if you didn't have no tough times, you wouldn't know what good times were. He take care of everybody and anybody, but that's just him. My problem is that I do not like people to take forward kindness for weakness. I have a problem with that. We can pick our friends, but we can't pick our family. So if he can pick his friends, and if he can pick the positive ones and distribute which ones are good and which ones are bad, he'll be a better person.
As anything we have ever seen from him.
I think to get just wiser, I think when you're 25, you're not gonna have the same mindset and the same mind frame as when you're 18. You're not gonna have the same mindset as if you're 21. And so then we reach 30.
What's going on else?
I don't think you'll have the same mindset or same mind frame. If you do, then time has been wasted, because you must grow.
I've never seen a fighter holding all the cards like Floyd Mayweather does. It's unprecedented.
Listen, man, you done took over the game. It ain't nobody for you to fight.
Who?
I thought about that too.
Who?
I fought every fucking body.
I mean, who? I don't know if this will ever be done again. And I mean, you gotta realize that what he's doing, the personality, the charisma, the fighting skills. I mean, this man, and obviously, he's trying to please the public.
There's one guy you can fight. If Ortiz knocked Berto out, you can give him a rematch. That's about it. Yeah. If he flatlined Berto, he can come back and
say, if Berto beat him, then I can fight Berto.
That ain't gonna, Berto.
Knocked him motherfucker out.
Right, but what I'm saying is this.
Actually, when I was a kid, I used to always say, we're gonna be richer than the Jacksons. I was talking about Michael Jackson. We have a lot of cars, we have a real, real big house. And it was cool, it was cool. Everyone says that my life is not normal, but I think it's normal. I don't know. I think it's normal to drive a Rolls Royce. I think it's normal to drive a Bentley. I've been living like this since I've been a teenager. I dreamed this. This was destined to happen.
I'd be locked up this whole summer. I said, huh? It's okay. I may well, I don't trip on nothing.
It's my team don't think I'm bougie, do they? I think I'm down to earth. It is what it is.
From the slums, man. G-Rap. If you ever go to Grand Rapids, Michigan, you'll see what it is. You know, and people, some people don't have nothing to live for there. They just hustle all day long. I always ask him, what would you do if you wasn't boxing? You know, he'll probably be in the streets just like everybody else, doing what they do, trying to make some money. Before he was in his 20s, you know, we was running wild in Vegas and, you know, really didn't have a care in the world. We thought we was above everybody. He changed a lot, became a man more.
You know, hey, it looks like that.
Boyd's gym's right there. He's been there for like, what, six and a half years? I've been here for 10. Having him over here has just been a blessing. It's unbelievable, you know? 6 weeks out of the training camp, we get him nonstop. He's got kids coming in here. He's training kids left and right. That's all he loves to do is train the kids. He likes the next generation. That's all he cares about. But in any business, that means you got to give back. And you can't find a CEO that takes all the money and don't give back that's still successful. That's why he's still running. He gives back. Floyd is basically Vegas. Since he made this his home. He's lived here. He's donated to the community. He's part of us.
I just want to ride you all night long.
His fights do so much for this town. It's insane. Not to mention what he does in his personal life and where he lives and giving back to the community and all the people that he takes care of out here that work for him and et cetera, et cetera.
Jesus, stop the music. What was that, really though?
Yeah.
I don't think I'm untouchable nowhere. I think I'm blessed.
What's up, baby? What's up?
There he is.
I know some cool people and some cool places. I think people think like Floyd, like, oh, he's a big shot. He's this, he's that. I'm not saying that. I'm just me. You want to get love and you want to get treated right in Vegas, you treat people right. You treat people with respect.
Vegas!
No one owes me nothing but respect. That's all I ask. I've been good to the city. Not good, great. When you tally up everything as far as the liquor, flights, rental cars, hotel rooms, clothes, gas, car services, parties, close circuit, gambling, it can easily be $1 billion that I bring to the city in, you know, 3 days.
Love you, Daddy.
Yeah.
Thanks for
checking.
Yeah, thank you, Daddy.
I guess everybody.
I know this hallway. I've done record-breaking numbers in this hallway. I feel this vibe in this hallway.
All I do is focus on my art, right? Put it to the side, right? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I focus on my art and be who I am.
Yeah.
We can't change. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people worry about. They fall short because they worry about who judging them,
yep.
Who looking at them.
Yep.
If they didn't make no noise, then that's when you.
That's when.
That's when you got to worry. So right now, so everywhere you go, they gonna make noise.
Yes, sir.
Because
yes,
you're relevant.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And you keep making good music, you're gonna stay relevant.
Yes, sir.
What they say, the music business and the boxing business are the two worst businesses to be involved with. There's so many leeches. Everyone always have their hand out. And I think that they think that sometimes entertainers and athletes have more than what they really have. What I was talking to Drake about being a living legend. And I told him he has the potential and the talent to be the next Tupac, to be the next Biggie.
I know I'll beat you there. Yeah.